Hey guys, it's Roger President, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode. Where last time after I picked up another win in the Champions League group stages by defeating Roma, and I picked up a win in the league over Sunderland. In this episode, I have Arsenal in the league before I play Schalke in my third group stage game in the Champions League. So, let's get into it. Excuse me.
Hi there, everybody. Alan Smith alongside me, Martin Tyler. In the commentary box, it's with great view up here, Alan, and a great game, I think, in prospect.
Yeah, we've got the best seats in the house, and looking forward to an entertaining match here.
Well, Arsenal taking on Liverpool, and whenever these teams meet, obviously your mind turns to the game at Anfield in 1989.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah, nice early goal
in Football League history, wasn't it? I hope we'll get just a fraction of the drama here today. If we do, we're in for a treat.
This is the Arsenal lineup. Starting in goal, Oblak. Samuel Umtiti plays with Omer Toprak as the centre backs. Francis Coquelin plays with Mohamed Elneny in the centre of the pitch. And they just go, it's a quick break.
Spurs.
Very weak challenge.
Shot on! It's a real shame that happened to Wilshere, because he was actually, it actually looked like he was actually going to survive if the whole season without getting an injury. And then, out of nowhere, he gets injured. It's apparently a leg break, so he won't be playing the remainder of the
responsibility.
Season.
It's definitely an own goal.
It is. You'd like to try and defend him, but he just didn't make up his mind quickly.
The early goal I wanted, Hector Bellerin is not going to be too happy with his part in the goal. It's an own goal, for sure.
Bad enough to be behind now,
the Spaniard.
An own goal. It's particularly annoying for the
who,
team.
And
the
may or may question. Not be leaving Arsenal in the Jack summer. Wilshere. Some conflicting rumours. Some Arsenal fans.
And in he goes with the tackle. Elneny.
May not be too happy to see him go, but some.
Now they've got the chance to push forward.
Considering his recent form, some might be like, well, he's not. Anyway, be sure in the foot.
He has been pressed there to running the ball out of play.
Like I said, conflicting time for Arsenal fans.
Jack Wilshere, and it's now with Liverpool.
This could
onto the attack.
Real life could this could be quite possibly the worst season to be an Arsenal fan. Not only could this be the first season under Arsene Wenger that they don't
Jack Wilshere
won't finish in the top four and qualify for Champions
Mohamed
League.
Elneny.
Well, he makes that transition
this could
happen
also
quickly.
See them, well, they are going to finish under Spurs. There's no way they're not going to. But
Elneny.
Spurs might. They still have a very good Mohamed chance Elneny. Of winning the Premier League.
Liverpool take over possession again.
I'm no Arsenal fan, but I can imagine that would define a very bad season.
Challenges
for
the
first time in Arsene Wenger's 20 years at the club that you don't get top four, and in the same season your closest rival, who you've been, you know, head and shoulders above for ages, is. Come good and become the champions. I mean, it just seems like it would be an Arsenal nightmare.
Time to get the ball in.
And I don't want to scare any Arsenal fans, but I think they know that it's a possibility, especially
Roberto Firmino.
Good Chelsea now having lost two games recently
starting
in the Premier League, losing the Palace and then losing the Manchester United.
Foul against Liverpool.
Chelsea do have a game in hand over Spurs, which is which could help.
For EA Sports, the EuroLeague fixture, Arsenal, they'll be hosting Udinese.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. There's two good sides coming
in. I mean, they're a pursuit of the title, because that could easily make the gap 7 points. But can you more drop points? And you're like, it's... I think if Spurs can... If Chelsea lose one more game, I think it will be Spurs' to lose. Now, at the end of the season, last season, Spurs imploded and lost their second place spot to Arsenal on the last day.
And he could get away here.
And even Arsenal fans know that was a false second place finish.
They've got a firmer grip on the game now.
Which you can hear them talk about.
We've got to admire the way he placed the ball into the bottom corner of the net.
But the goalkeeper was in a decent position. He was
on the Arsenal fan TV. Going in. Yeah, I've heard Arsenal fan TV, the regular DT, mention it a few times. So they know it was they shouldn't have finished above of Spurs last season. I mean, anyone with a brain could have told you that.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
But this season, it's definitely going to be a case where, like, there's no way Arsenal will finish above
Spurs. Here.
Unless, I don't even think if, like...
Tackle here.
I don't have the table open in front of me. I don't know if...
Oh, he's won it, but well, that's a really good tackle.
Spurs are actually only a few points ahead. 2-0. Bit of Liverpool are only a few points in themselves. A few
that
points
looks a big goal, the goal just before half time.
Like I said, I don't have the real life league table in front of me. Maybe while I load the second half, I can get it up quickly.
Start of the second half for you.
I don't want to take my focus off of the game. Won't continue. 3-0 for sure. Oh, the bar, are you king?
Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of better things to come. Kieran Gibbs. Danny Welbeck.
Oh, no, Chelsea don't have a game in hand. My apologies. Sorry for the scare if you're a Spurs fan. No need to worry. No alarm. Chelsea do not have a game in hand. I sit there like, wait, what game? I probably confused a lot of Spurs fans who just had to check their thing. Last time I looked at the league table, it was during Chelsea's game against Manchester United. I forgot my thing. Takes its time updating, so that's why Chelsea were still on 31.
Liverpool take over possession again.
With 6 games left.
What about Liverpool?
There's 4 points in it.
Foul called against Arsenal.
I honestly think if
card.
Chelsea lose one more game, it's Spurs league to lose.
Reckless.
Yeah, I think so.
Spurs themselves are only, I say only, 7 points. No wait, sorry, 5 points ahead of Liverpool. Carrying them compared to the wrong team. And Arsenal themselves are a bit further back. They're 9 points behind us in real life.
Away, trying to find room for a shot, maybe.
So, you add 5 and 9, that's 14.
And heads it towards goal. A header on target. But
Spurs.
Never
would have to lose all the remaining games. And Arsenal would have to win all the remaining games.
Really get the direction at all on it.
And Arsenal would finish 4 points above.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Looking to play his teammate through.
6-3
Get his foot in there.
Yeah. 4 points above Spurs, where so they'd be on 75 points. That's the most Arsenal can finish.
Happen quickly.
20 minutes of the 90 still to play.
Like,
here's Bellerin.
Spurs only need to win two more games, and then Arsenal cannot catch them. And of course, that all varies on what Arsenal do in their next two league games. I have to say league games because the FA Cup is next weekend for Arsenal and Spurs.
He'll get some stick from his teammates, especially if they lose this game.
I'm not quite sure.
Bit of pressure on the player. That's why it's.
Once Liverpool went out, I kind of stopped. Keeping track of
at any point in a game. He hasn't really looked like scoring any so far, has he? He'll be hoping for better as the match develops.
He's just looked a bit under the weather. I don't
Can
know
you blame me? Can you really blame me?
Not been his normal, sharp, bright self.
They're challenging each other. It's a change that's got to be made now to try and pep up the attack, to try and get back on level terms. They bring on the extra striker.
Yeah, this team has had its back to the wall for a while now, and they do need a bit more momentum.
Yeah, Spurs are playing Chelsea on Saturday, and Arsenal are playing on Sunday. I think it's one of the Manchester clubs. I think it might be City that plays. It's our City or United. I don't know why. I think
good position.
The
They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. The countdown is on. We're into 9 minutes now. It's an Arsenal substitute who's getting ready. This could be a chance.
Origi, clean through on goal. Surely he can make it 3-0. Oh wow.
No more ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
Coming onto the pitch.
Last ball.
Oh my god.
Get the injured man off and bring on a substitute.
Other. That's. Yeah, it is. It's Man City.
It goes out wide again. And the offside stops the play. Flag went up. Referee blue.
So, there's a possibility of an All-London, actually, there's a good possibility of an All-London final, but Arsenal will need to defeat Manchester City to make that happen. There's definitely going to be at least one London team in the final, because Chelsea are playing Spurs.
But I think that's the good call.
As we come to the end, it's a free kick here.
How interesting would it be if that were a league game?
Could be dangerous.
The referee has indicated
a lot can happen in
4 minutes.
Good passing, shrewd passing, accurate passing. That's the way he earns his
league. Especially if Spurs were to beat Chelsea.
Danny Welbeck.
You never know what can happen.
David Alaba. And that's a win confirmed.
There's the full-time whistle. But yeah. Exciting times in the Premier League. In real life.
Arsenal 0, Liverpool 2. Aston Villa 0, Manchester United 1. Everton 3, Newcastle United 0. Leicester City 1, Tottenham Hotspur 3.
Someone go open this train.
Manchester City 2, Bournemouth.
Really?
Southampton 1.
No one.
Sunderland 2. Stoke City 1.
I have no one.
Palace 2. Swansea City 1. Chelsea 2. So, what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 24 points.
You can see the
Chelsea with 20 points.
Table after the
third, Tottenham Hotspur.
Second set of games.
Points.
Yes, Schalke did lose their second
climbing
game.
Climbing the table are Manchester City
episode.
With 14 points.
A little bit of a spoiler,
in fifth,
but hey,
and falling are Arsenal with 13 points. In sixth, moving down, are Bournemouth
game,
with 13 points. In seventh,
start.
Rising up the table are Sunderland
little bit of a change between the two secondary teams. Moyes going to play
Southampton with 11 points. Side with bottom of the table, moving down, are Newcastle United.
In this side with points. David. And
then reading up the table, second bottom, climbing the table, are Norwich City with 4 points.
So, yeah.
Bottom, Watford with
little
5 points.
Little bit of a change. Not too
fourth
much.
Bottom and falling are Swansea City.
I completely forgot to put in Joe fourth Gomez at left back for one of the two teams, so
8 points.
He's in left back for the other team, and Rico Henry is sitting in here. Like I said, just the smallest changes to the teams in the game. If you missed the last episode, I discussed that this stops me needing having to change around the secondary team before.
We had a couple of games for each club now, and now we're on to match day three. Beginning to shape up.
Yeah, I think so. The group does begin to take shape, and we'll begin to see how many of the favourites to top it.
The game today, Liverpool, they will face.
Seems a lot of time, and
this is the Liverpool side. Well, it's 4-4-2 for them today. But we think the middle four might be a diamond, Alan.
Yeah, and it keeps
much easier. Really.
And no scraps for the attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time.
For myself, I'm only thinking, why didn't I think of doing this earlier?
So we're concentrating.
That's the only
these
thing.
Two lads as well.
They've done really well, but I think both have got scope for improvement, for development, because they're not old. And that bodes well for their teammates.
Good forward play from them. And it's Schalke winning the ball well.
Schalke was so far, like I said, lost both of their games.
That's a shot well off.
And they only lost them by the one goal, 2-1 against Roma and 1-0 against PSV.
Schalke setting off on
it. They've lost, but they've kept it competitive.
We'll take over possession.
Well,
again.
Judging from the scoreline, I can't see the facts. Match stats.
Good challenge here.
I think. I'm not suggesting this for FIFA 18, but that might be something EA should think about adding for a future FIFA. It doesn't have to be FIFA 18. But, you know, the ability to see match stats and scores and stuff like that.
The ball's loose. Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it.
It's all well and good being able to see the scores and being updated on the scores.
Attacking now.
They happen.
Now the shot. Good stop.
Damn it. Completely forgot to put on the check to get updates on the PSV.
Giveaway by Dennis O.
Roma game. Whoops, we'll have to check the scorelines at halftime and full time to see how.
Read the play well to intercept.
Their game will affect the group table. I mean, I'll be top regardless. Just to see who's got the upper hand between those two teams.
That will be Liverpool's throw.
Losing here will all but eliminate Schalke.
And there is some backup for him in this position. Choupo-Moting.
It won't film with confidence, that's for sure.
Attacking well here.
I don't know who my fourth
opportunity
game
to
is.
Cross it now.
Qualification. Score with Costa Ferreira.
Opened up again, but the difference is
take
this
the lead.
They put the ball past the goalkeeper.
I don't know why he's the captain.
And they're looking at very classy.
Doesn't bother me. It's just why he is. He just gave it to him.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
If you're new and wondering who this kid is, he's Kaká's region.
Meyer. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. And it's Schalke winning the ball well. Aogo.
I was trying to buy him or Lampard or Gerrard
at this stage. We've got half-time coming up.
Pirlo's. He was the only one whose club was like, yeah, you can have him. He's been so good, I just never went back for the other regents. I think they're still there. I think they are all still there. It's hard to tell which one's Lampard's regen and which one is Gerrard's regen.
There'll be no leniency here. It's got to be a card, a yellow one.
Yeah, he reached for that.
Because they're both English centre mids.
And out it came.
Which one is which?
They cope with it well defensively. Shot on! That's a spectacular save. Not turning the ball around, he's hung on to it. I spotted the pass and cut it out.
They're storage! Ray with the save.
Well, here's a chance to show how good they are at corners and maybe increase their advantage.
Ray. So perhaps?
He's blocked the shot well.
Maybe he's farming.
That's a good spot by the defender. Shots on here.
See, now I don't know how old farming is.
Last half time at 1-0.
I always thought he was like 27, 28 or something like that. Not, you know, it'd be old for an outfielder, but for a keeper, not so much. PSV are beating Roma 1-0. That would put them into second place. They've recovered well from losing to me in the opening
second half of this third match, remember, in the group stage of the Champions Cup.
Seemed to be in good position there. Themselves qualified.
It'll open up a little bit.
But that's how they bounce back from Fe.
Well, it will be.
Still,
it's gone out of
facing me a second time.
Good forward play from them. Choupo-Moting. Meyer. Good challenge.
Guevara. Costa Pereira.
He's got his shot off now. Well, he's not
managed
time, but...
Oh, it might dip.
I'm sure he'll keep on trying.
Well, he loves dipping, but...
He's had a decent game out there, and his confidence should be high after that earlier goal.
Just a little nudge. To nudge you in the direction of what's coming up on EA Sports for you, our coverage of the Premier League fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Southampton.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
There were more.
And here's the shot.
Ah!
The shooting, but it wasn't a very good shot. Daniel Sturridge, here's a chance to attack.
Costa Pereira!
Quite this time, scored already.
Thought when the keeper dove, thought my shot might get snaked its way in.
So well.
Ah. That's why it freaking flew off that direction. Kind of like hit it with the wrong side of his boot.
And it's been... an hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go. And
that's why the keeper goes that way. I thought there was like a deflection. That's why the keeper was like offside in the wrong way.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
Of course, if there were a deflection with a corner.
The header. Hit the post! Stopped emphatically and just as well.
There's no error.
Play looked very encouraging.
Yeah. I'll stop him. He is quick as hell. He'll cause me problems if I let him.
Free kick awarded against Liverpool.
Oh wow, the referee showed a little bit of leniency for a player.
20 minutes of the 90 still to play.
And Bergen.
There's good progress
breaking
in this attack.
He's using what pace he has left.
It's come off the goalkeeper, still in play.
Oh, that's it. Who apparently will be playing in the Premier League next season. He's actually apparently been signed to a pre-contract agreement by Arsenal, funnily enough.
See with these possession stats, Alan, that yes, the game has been as even as it seemed. The figures to back that up.
Yeah.
It might be a bit worrying if you're a Schalke fan.
Evenly matched.
This is the second season in a row this is after happening. I mean, I don't know a lot about Klopp, but if he's anything like, if he performs as well for Arsenal as Joe Matip has so far for the season for Liverpool, he might be a fantastic acquisition from Arsene Wenger. May or may not be on his way out. Who knows?
Phases in the game where they've looked vulnerable, and the win that they deserve should soon be claimed. Still 1-0 here, with the time almost up. What about this impacting on their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Southampton after this, and certainly not.
Well, that's straightforward for the goalkeeper. It's the keeper who's sending out the message here.
Doing as they're told as well. Look at him.
Win the header. Win the header.
Keep possession with that header. And the cross
force him out wide.
Well, crossing is a skill. Ooh. And that's not a very good example.
Oh, I almost made a huge mistake. I should pass that back to the keeper and latched it down the pitch.
He does read the game well, this lad.
And the time to be added on here is a minute.
There might be one
minutes.
For attack. It's 2v. He won against how it is. Sturridge!
There's the man, Daniel Sturridge. Has delivered again in front of goal.
Gets in. A bit of.
Well, it's good competition with goalkeeping in this team, and I think he might just be going down the pecking order after this.
Well, goes a long way.
You make a mistake, and invariably comes back to haunt you, and that was a big mistake.
I don't know why I was going for it there. Daniel Sturridge. He scored a third goal in the competition. And, I'm going to be Schalke by a two-goal margin. A little bit more damage to their
this has been a real
goal difference, doesn't it? Ah, well. PSV and Roma ended up 1-1. Fantastic. The reason I'm saying fantastic because Champions now Cup. I Chelsea am in full Athletic control. I was already in Juventus full control of the
Celtic nil.
Group stages of
Liverpool
the,
2,
my group
Schalke
the Champions
nil.
League. But Manchester this 2, further cements that.
PSV 1, Roma 1, Tottenham Hotspur 0.
Quickly show you the group stage, how they stand now, before I end the episode. You have a quick look at the Premier League table as well, while we're here. Here we go, Europa League, Champions League. You'll see the oh, I didn't think I was C. Okay. Oh well. Five. Two. Oh no, that's right. It was good. I forgot it was a 2-1 Roma beat Schalke by. That's why they've conceded five. And, there you can see why it's really good for me. 5-point gap to Roma and PSV. Schalke are in no man's land. On 0 points. Not ideal after 3 games. So that gives me a slim possibility, slightly slim possibility, of winning the group stage in the next game, depending on who I play. I don't think it'll work if I'm playing Schalke again. Let me just check. My next two games are Southampton and Spurs. That'll be the next episode. It's Roma. Okay, so if I beat Roma, I'm guaranteed qualify. But if PSV do not beat Schalke, then I will also win the group with two games to spare. PSV need to beat Schalke. If I beat Roma, say, for instance, this is not the case, but if PSV were playing after me, like if there was a gap between the two games, PSV would go into that game 8 points behind me. Only a win could bring it down below six again with two games remaining. A draw would only bring it down to seven. So, but they'll be playing at the same time as me, so it'll be a crucial game following the game against Chelsea. Some big games coming up. Man City, Man United as well. Some big games coming up. So, if you are not already, make sure you smash the subscribe button so you don't miss a future episode, because these games are going to be full of drama, action, and excitement. And, of course, there'll be plenty more to come in future episodes. As for this episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you do enjoy. Hit subscribe if you are new to the channel. Also, you don't miss future episodes and other stuff that I do. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.